Good evening and welcome to Your Call. It's the only show on Indian television where you're in the anchor's seat. You, the viewer, can ask your question directly to our personality who's come in on the show. They range from politicians, businessmen, achievers, social activists, sports people and entertainers. How do you do it? Well, it's simple. You can just dial the number which is on the screen right now. You can log on to our website on ndtv.com. You can access our accounts on Twitter and Facebook. You can also go across to the satellite vans in any of our major cities and just ask your question. Well, tonight's guest is an Indian who's got probably one of the most challenging tasks at the moment, the task of giving a unique identity to every citizen. Joining me tonight is Mr. Nandan Nilekani. Thank you so much for coming in, Mr. Nilekani. We know that you're no stranger to challenges, so let's just take a look. Thanks so much for joining us on the show tonight. In your book, Nandan, you talked about the ideas that have shaped and will shape India. I think what's fascinated so many people with the project you're now heading is the idea behind it. What drew you to this and what would you explain to our viewers as the big idea?
Well, you know, when I did this book, this actually popped up as one of the big challenges in India, which is to give every Indian resident an identity. Because the people in this country, especially the poor who have no identity, are losing out and being left out of the system. They can't access the public services. They can't really get opportunity. And therefore, the compelling big idea here is that if you give every Indian, especially a poor Indian, a number, then they can better access opportunity for their lives.
How will this be different from other government projects that we've seen before?
In identity or in general?
In implementation.
Well, we hope to have a very tight implementation. We have promised that we'll have the first set of numbers issued in 12 to 18 months and a few hundred million numbers in 5 years. So we have a very good team that we're putting together, both from the government and from the from outside. And some of the best technology people want to volunteer for this project. So we hope we can bring all these people together and make it happen.
What was actually the clincher which brought you to this project? We know that, of course, when you get a call from the Prime Minister, it is hard to refuse. But was this an idea that had come up through conversations? Did you know about this project beforehand? How did it finally actually come to be?
Well, this project has been around for some time and it was taking shape. And in the meantime, the Prime Minister was kind enough to invite me to play some role in the government. And when this particular thing was discussed, it seemed to be the logical thing to do because on the one hand, it was something that had the potential to have a lot of impact. And secondly, it played to my strengths because of my technology background. I'd be able to bring that kind of, managing large technology projects kind of background to the table. So it seemed to be a perfect fit, a technology-based project which has a social impact.
What excited you the most about it and what scared you the most about it?
Well, I think the exciting thing is that if this is done well, if people have numbers, and then on top of that, if our public service delivery systems are redesigned to use these numbers in an effective manner, then it can have a big impact on governance and impact on public services for the poor. And, you know, we've been talking for years about governance reforms and all that. So this would count as one of those. And as I said, one of the reasons I took it up was the extraordinary support I got from Prime Minister Manmohan Singh and his colleagues. They went out of the way to make me feel at home. They've been very generous and gracious and given all the support. And that gives me the confidence to take this on.
Tubar.com.